This video is brought to you by catbeast.com. Design your own custom snapbacks and hats.
Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another video on this channel. The NBA season is really dry at this stage. There's not a whole lot going on. There's obviously the FIBA World Cup, which is really interesting. But outside of the FIBA World Cup, there's really not a whole lot going on. So in this video, I want to talk about three things. One is the Dwight Howard situation and my thoughts on him joining the Lakers, because I haven't really covered that on this channel yet and I think it's interesting, but I just don't want to make a whole separate video on that topic because I really just don't think it deserves its whole video. I think it's just something I want to talk about. The second and third thing I want to talk about are two rumors. I think it's really interesting when we discuss rumors on this channel because they haven't happened yet, but they're just rumors. But there's always something with rumors that kind of sways us in a certain direction compared to if it was just like a random rumor, like Carmelo Anthony to the Brooklyn Nets. We're going to talk about, obviously, Kyrie and Kevin Durant want him, which means that it is something that is really possible. And the third thing is Andre Iguodala to the Los Angeles Clippers, with Doc Rivers, the head coach of the Clippers, liking an Instagram post of Andre Iguodala in a Clippers jersey. It's a rumor, but there's something there. So we're going to discuss all three in this video. So if you enjoy these videos, be sure to subscribe, leave a like if you're new, and let me know what videos you guys want to see on this channel, because it's a really dry time of year with no NBA. So I want to know what you guys want to see on this channel. And without further ado, let's get into it. I want to thank today's sponsor, catbeast.com. If you want to make your own snapbacks and custom hats, be sure to click the link down below in the description box below. Would you believe me if I told you that Carmelo Anthony, the last time he played, in fact, last season with the Houston Rockets, he scored 22 points on 52%, 24 points the game after on 44%. He did have an off game in between, scoring only 8 points on 16%, but what matters to me is the way that you can bounce back from a performance like that. He then scored 28 points on 75% field goal shooting against the Brooklyn Nets, and then finished that off with a 17-point performance the next game. Only 5 days later, he was waived and never picked up since. Carmelo Anthony, despite what people say about him, is still a scorer and a guy that you could use whether it's off the bench or as a starting player in this league, and I truly believe that. Yeah, obviously he did have some poor games last season, but so do many other players in this league. Carmelo Anthony, of course, is going to have some bad games, just like he had some good games. 22, 24, and 28 points in a 4-game stretch last season. I mean, it shows that he can still perform. And now, obviously, for him not to be on a team is pretty devastating. And honestly, I think he should be on a team. And I do believe it will be the Brooklyn Nets. And here's why. First of all, before I can get into that, we have to understand that there has been a change in the way that people are viewing Carmelo Anthony, and this has been a league-wide perception, including fans as well. People seem to hate on Melo based off what the media have said about Melo, but if people looked at Melo in a different light, maybe he would have been picked up by another team last season and actually played after Houston. His representatives have obviously tried to change the narrative in the way that people view Melo. I mean, we've seen him go on ESPN, we've seen him have talks and interviews, and he's obviously come out and tried to get in the media in order to change the way that people view him, which I think is working. In my opinion, I think he's been the scapegoat for a few teams that really didn't live up to their potential. In Oklahoma, you had Paul George and Russell Westbrook with Carmelo Anthony. Who are you going to blame? Carmelo. When you have James Harden and Chris Paul and you're starting off the year very slow, who are you going to blame? Carmelo. So obviously there's been a lot of people that have just jumped on that bandwagon, and I believe he can still play, and it's not because of the videos that we've seen online, and it's not because of what he said in the media or what his representatives have said. It's simply due to the fact that I saw him play in Houston and I saw him perform on the court, but he was always going to be the scapegoat. So why should he join the Brooklyn Nets then? Well, number one, Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant have both stated that they want him. If those are the two biggest stars on a franchise, and they're new stars on a franchise that haven't even played a game on that franchise, I feel like the franchise should listen to them. They are their star players, and this does not mean that Melo will go straight into a starting small forward role. Simply because, well, he obviously hasn't been in the league for a while. And I think we all know this, and even Melo knows it himself now, that he probably isn't a starting player anymore.
Accepting a role that I might not normally would have accepted in the past. Mm-hmm. I don't mind coming off. I've done it. I've came off the bench in Houston 10 days. We don't know how that worked. I don't mind coming off the bench. That's not an issue with me.
Why should somebody believe Carmelo Anthony when he says that?
Because I'm speaking my truth. I never do this. I never speak out about this.
Even when he failed to recognize that, even just last season, I feel like now he knows, and he's come out and said it. That doesn't mean he can't be a starting player for a few games, especially if obviously a guy like Kevin Durant is injured. The second thing is, he's reportedly been working out with the Brooklyn Nets. Now, the Brooklyn Nets are in search for a small forward. It has been said that they're working out Joe Johnson, who dominated the Big 3 League, Melo, and obviously a few other guys that they see fitting to work with the Brooklyn Nets. And I feel like if it's Melo or Joe Johnson, they may go towards Joe Johnson simply because he really knows his role. But if we're going on talent, either way you could look at it. Joe Johnson is a great player. Maybe he is in a bit better shape, but we don't really know that. I guess the Brooklyn Nets will know that before anybody. But from what we have seen, Melo is in pretty good shape. And if you're going to choose a shooter, and if we're going off somebody that's recently played in this league, well, it's Melo because he just played last season. The one thing for me is that Melo just has a lot left to give. He needs to be on a team that is trying to get him a ring, and whether he wants that ring or not, it doesn't really matter at this point. He just wants to play, but the Brooklyn Nets are very interesting. If he can perform at some sort of level, he may be able to stay on this team, and when Kevin Durant comes back, he may have that real chance to get a ring next season, if he can even get on the team this season and performs at some sort of level. The online sports media has definitely tried to paint a fake narrative towards Melo, and I just disagree with it completely. So that's what I have to say about Melo, and I reckon he could be on a Brooklyn Nets jersey next season. Let's get on to the next topic. So, Dwight Howard is obviously a member of the Los Angeles Lakers now. After DeMarcus Cousins got hurt, they obviously needed to go after a center. I really thought they'd go after a guy like Kenneth Faried. I just thought he would be more of a stretch player in this league today. He is undersized and he isn't a center, but he's a guy that shows hustle, rebounding, and scoring. But if you're looking at a better player than him, you would have to say it's Dwight Howard. I just didn't think they really wanted him in the locker room, but it makes sense. I said in that video where I talked about Kenneth Faried and DeMarcus Cousins, I did say that Dwight Howard was the best player available, but I just didn't think they were going to go after him simply due to the fact that he was there 6 years ago and it didn't really work out. What I'm interested to see is how the Lakers fans react to Dwight Howard. Will they boo him? Will they accept him? What's going to happen? Because he isn't the Dwight Howard that was there 6 years ago. In fact, the Dwight that was there 6 years ago was still a very, very good player. But he obviously isn't the Dwight Howard from Houston or Orlando. This is an older version of Dwight Howard that has basically been out of the league for the same time as Melo was last season. Dwight Howard was a beaten man last season. He had back surgery and obviously he just wasn't himself playing in Washington. But when he did play, he was actually a very solid player. He just didn't have the explosiveness and the athleticism, but he has shown in recent footage, if you look up Dwight Howard recently, he looks like he's got some of that back. So what does it mean for the Lakers now? If you have guys like Rajon Rondo and LeBron James as your facilitators on a team with Dwight Howard, I believe that no matter what, they will feed him the ball. They've got Davis, of course, but Davis has stated that he does not want to play center whatsoever. You're not going to want to have JaVale McGee as your starting center for the entirety of this season. He's obviously going to need a break, and a guy that can fill in for 10, 15, 20 minutes per game is Dwight Howard. He can rebound, he can score, he's a guy that blocks shots. At the peak of his power, he was unstoppable and the best big man in the game. If he can just tap into a little bit of what he was in his past playing days, then he's going to be a great player for the Lakers, no doubt. Not the Dwight Howard we once saw, but a great player for the team. Not to mention, he has a $0 salary protection, which means that every day that Dwight Howard is on the Lakers, he will earn just under $15,000 for every day he is on the roster. But that roster position will start on October the 21st. If they waive him, then he doesn't get paid out whatsoever. So it's a win-win in my opinion for the Lakers. But either way, his contract is $2.5 million, which is obviously a very small amount for a guy that was once one of the highest players in the league. Which means that he's obviously there to win and not mess around. Otherwise, he will be out of the league next season. And if he actually plays well, he may stay around for a little bit longer and win a championship, which is what he wants. So I don't think it's a loss for the Lakers at all. Lastly, I want to talk about Andre Iguodala to the Los Angeles Clippers. Obviously, I told you about head coach Doc Rivers liking a post on Instagram claiming that Iggy will join the franchise. If this is true and Iggy gets waived by the Grizzlies and actually does join the Los Angeles Clippers, This is going to be very exciting to watch. We know that Iggy is obviously one of the best defenders that the league has ever seen, and yes, ever. But he's also reaching the end of his career. Obviously, he's not going to play the minutes he once played, and he's not going to be the player he once was, but he's probably going to have a similar impact to the way he played last season with the Warriors. He came off the bench, and he didn't really have a big impact. He only scored 5.7 points, had 3.7 rebounds, and 3.2 assists per game last season with the Warriors. He did shoot 50% and shot 33% from beyond the arc, but what Iggy brings to a Clippers team is it allows a guy like Kawhi Leonard to rest a little bit more. Paul George can rest a little bit more as well if they're both suffering with injuries throughout the season. Obviously, we know that Kawhi had a lot of rest days last season and Paul George is coming off a shoulder injury, which means a guy like Iggy could be a good replacement for a few games here and there until the playoffs start, in which he will be a very, very handy player. I mean, we already know about the Clippers' defense. You've got Kawhi, Paul George, Patrick Beverley, Montrezl Harrell, and if you add in a guy like Iggy to that, well, it's going to be very, very fun to watch, and it's going to be interesting to see how they manage all these players together. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think about any of them. Will Dwight Howard fit with the Lakers? Will Melo join the Nets? Will Iggy join the Clippers? I want to know what you guys think down below. If you're new around here, be sure to hit that subscribe button, leave a like, follow me on Instagram, and hit the notification button so you don't miss an upload. And with that said, I'm out.
Peace. You gotta focus on what's real, man.